Got some email questions and a little time left to address them. This is Eileen, who says, Pat, what do you do when you've been falsely accused, then proven not guilty by the law, yet rumors spread by accusers begin to plague your life? Is there any way to get my good name back?
Well, look, Jesus was accused of all kinds of things. He was going to tear down the temple. He was going to undermine the Jewish faith and all the rest of it.
He was a fraud.
He was a fraud, sure. He was illegitimate, you know. Mm-hmm. He wasn't the Son of God. Well, he didn't defend himself. Don't you defend yourself. You let God defend you. The greatest defense is to be righteous and to accomplish something. And you get on with your life and you accomplish something. And don't worry about that other. People have short memories. Whatever rumor's going around, they'll forget it. Mm-hmm. And the Bible says, a curse causeless cannot lie. In other words, if a curse is coming at you and it has no cause and no validity, it can't stick. That's what the Bible says. It won't stick. All right.
This is Betty, who says, Dear Pat, I'm very troubled about an incident that occurred at a Bible study I regularly attend at my church. Members of the study told me that the Bible came from the Quran. Is there any truth to this, and how should I respond?
Well, I would say this is colossal ignorance, and you're appalled that people in the Christian faith could be so stupid. Muhammad lived like 622. The Bible goes all the way back to Moses at 1300 B.C. The Quran borrowed huge sections of the Bible, many references to Moses and things like that, because Muhammad was copying the Bible, not the other way around.
Well, you'd really want to know you were in a study, too, where somebody who was leading it had better knowledge
something.
Than that.
You know something. I mean, gosh. Just good grief. Anyhow.
Okay, this is Ariel, who says, My mother and I are both very religious. She's a born-again Christian, while I'm not yet. I hope to become born again soon. I'm in my 20s and live with her. I want to go away to grad school, but my mother says I can't become born again if I'm not living in her house because I won't be living under the influence of another Christian. Is this true?
Totally false. Totally false. But look, all you've got to do is bow your head and say, Jesus, come into my heart. I mean, it isn't something that you're going to work up to or you've got to spend 4 years in some monastery. I mean, you just bow your head and say, Lord, I surrender to you. Come in. Be my Savior. I receive you. That's it.
And then Boom. Take him to grad school with you.
And then take him to grad school with you. All right. We got, I guess that's all the time we've got.
Thanks
for your questions.